Hello everyone and welcome to the RV Inspection and Care Channel. I'm Dwayne and I'm a certified RV inspector. Unfortunately, I'm a little hoarse from allergies, but we'll get through this video anyway. And today we're going to talk about the top three ways that you can save money on campground costs. Now, the tips that I'm going to share with you are really mainly for part-time RVers, full-time RVers, you know, people like that that are moving from campground to campground. However, you weekenders can get some pretty good suggestions as well. And it's mainly for folks that are RVing on a budget, because if you don't have a budget, you don't need one. You've got enough money to stay anywhere you want to stay, well then campground costs aren't important to you. But if you need to keep campground costs under control, then the three ways I'm going to share with you are some of the three best ways I've found to do that. Now, let's mention as well that campground costs really need to be kept under control because they are the biggest expense that most RVers are going to face. Now, let's take an average cost of about $30 a night for staying at campgrounds, and that may be even a little low. But at $30 a night, if you stay at campgrounds 365 days a year for full hookups, you're going to spend about $11,000 a year. I mean, that's a lot of money. So the purpose of this video is to see how can we take that $11,000 and really knock it down. Let's really knock down the cost of campgrounds. And so the methods that I'm going to share with you today are the three best ways that I know of to do that. We're not going to talk about boondocking because boondocking will really save you a lot of money, no question about it. We're just talking about saving on campgrounds. And let's get started with the number one way to save on campground costs that I know of. And this is going to be a little controversial, and I know that, but I'm going to recommend that you consider a Thousand Trails membership. Now, Thousand Trails is a membership system with parks all across the United States, and it's a little controversial as well. We're not going to get into a discussion here on whether Thousand Trails campgrounds fits your lifestyle or not, or whether they're in the areas you want to RV in or not, or whether they have the amenities that you want or not. Those are all issues that are hashed out in great degree online, and we'll talk about those in another video. But what we're going to cover today is the Thousand Trails campground system being used for just one purpose, and that purpose is to save money on campground costs. So I believe you can do that. Here's how I recommend you do that. Don't start off with one of the more expensive memberships. In my opinion, it's a really good idea to just start off with a zone pass. That's what we did. You kind of get used to the Thousand Trails system doing that, and then you can decide whether you want to go further. But if you really want to save on campground costs, then the membership I recommend is the Basic Elite membership that has the Trails Collection added to it. And let's explain what that means. In the Thousand Trails park system, the Elite membership allows you access to 81 parks across the United States. But if you add the Trails Collection to it, that adds another 108 Encore resorts and parks across the U.S. as well. So you wind up with 189 parks to stay at across the country. And that's really pretty good. That's a lot of parks to choose from. Now, the cost of an Elite membership to buy into it, a one-time cost, is about $4,500 or a little less at the time of this video for that Elite membership on the resale market. Now, that's the way that Sherry and I bought our membership, and it's worked out very well for us. So we would recommend that you consider that as well, because you can save a couple thousand dollars on the resale market as opposed to buying new from Thousand Trails. Now, that cost again is a one-time cost. Now, once you buy that membership, it's yours for life. There are yearly costs associated in addition to that. And that is that you have your dues for 1,000 trails. And then if you have the 1,000 or the trails collection, that's going to cost you extra as well. Together, they'll be about $850 a year. Now, if you stayed in the 1,000 trails system the whole year, and there are many people that actually do that, at $850 a year, that's a little over $2 a night for full hookups. I don't know how you can beat that. But what about that $4,500 initial buy-in? Well, here's a way that we feel we're recovering that right away. Sherry and I have a 90-day trip lined up across the U.S. And in that trip, we're going to spend only 7 days out of the 1,000 Trails system. So 83 days are in 1,000 Trails. Now, if we were going to spend an average of $30 a night for those 83 days, it would be almost $2,500 that it would cost us that we are saving instead by being in 1,000 Trails. Now, think about that. That's only 90 days, a quarter of a year. So it's very easy for you to recover the cost of your membership, your elite membership, in the first year and start saving money. And then every year from there on, all you have are your dues and the trails collection costs. And that's, again, a little over $2 a night. So I have to say, I don't know how you can get full hookups for any lower cost than that. That's my number one recommendation, is look into 1,000 Trails as a campground membership and decide whether or not it's good for you. But it's certainly a good way to save money. Now, my number two suggestion is to also consider buying a Passport America membership. This one's only $44 a year. And the advantage is Passport America is all across the country. In a lot of places, 1,000 Trails isn't. And although it won't knock your costs down as low as 1,000 Trails, they advertise 50% off of campground costs. So if there's an average of $30 a night, it's not bad to save half of that, is it? And have only a $15 a night campground cost. So Passport America is certainly another way that you can save really good money on campground costs, really almost anywhere across the country. There's usually a Passport America campground close by to almost everywhere in the country. Now, finally, my third tip is, don't be in such a hurry. Don't be so quick about moving that you miss the advantage of getting deeper discounts for staying longer. Almost every campground will give you weekly rates and especially monthly rates that are deeply discounted. So if you just move every couple of days, you'll never see those discounts. Instead, find some areas where you really like them and you want to be in there for that area for a while and get those deeper discounts by staying longer. And here's another way to take that to a whole new level. What Sherry and I have found is that if you get into an area, start calling around to the mobile home parks in the area and ask them if they allow RVs to stay there. What you may find is that many mobile home parks allow RVers to stay with full hookups for much less than RV parks will, or especially what's called RV resorts. You know, that as soon as it's a resort, the price goes up for some reason. So anyway, consider that. Consider the idea of staying at a mobile home park that has full hookups instead of campgrounds. To give you an idea of how that can save, We like to spend a few months in the Southwest during the winter, and that's the high season for the Southwest. It's not uncommon to find, you know, daily or nightly campground costs of 60 or 70 or more a night. And yet we've found mobile home parks that allow us to stay with full hookups for about $22 a night at the same time that everybody else is paying those big dollars. So that's another way that you can save on campground costs. Slow down, stay in an area for a while, get the deeper discounts, and see if you can save by staying at mobile home parks instead of RV parks. Well, that's my top three ways to save on campground costs. There are other ways, but those are the three that I wanted to share with you today. If you found some points of benefit here, would you do me a favor and please like the video on YouTube? That's a big help for us YouTube creators. And if you have anything that you can add to this discussion about saving on campgrounds or some of the things we talked about, you may have a different opinion about it. Feel free to leave those comments in the comments section below. We'd love to hear what you have to say. Also, keep in mind that there's a lot more information on RVing and the RV lifestyle on my website, and you'll find that at rvinspectionandcare.com. So be sure to visit there and check out my articles on RVing as well. Finally, we would love to have you as part of our online RVing family. In order to do that, all you have to do is just hit that subscribe button, and that way you won't miss any of the videos that we're putting out on a weekly basis. Well, that's it for now. Have safe and happy travels, my friends. Until next time.